First, let us play a game called GWCII. Guess which city is it? I will give you some basic introduction about the city I've been living for over 9 years, and you just need to simply guess which city is it. In this city, there are in total 16 districts. It covers 16,000 square kilometers, with population roughly 21 million. The local language is Beijing dialect, or Beijing Hua. This city is the capital of China. The city flower is Chinese rose, and Chinese scholar is the city tree. So do you know which city am I talking about? The answer seems pretty obvious. It is Beijing, my home city, and I would love to introduce you about Beijing based on 5 parts. Politic, culture, global, research and development, and Beijing spirit. So first, let us look through the first part, politic. Throughout history, Beijing already exists for over 3,400 years. As a result, Beijing is a pretty old city, but that doesn't mean Beijing was as powerful as now during that time. Beijing really gained its political influence from 1271, when Yuan Dynasty ruled all of China. For the first time, Beijing became the capital of China. And from that on, through Yuan Dynasty, to Ming Dynasty, to Qing Dynasty, or even till now, none of the other city could replace the political function of Beijing. Beijing is now really the political center of China. It is where the central government is, and where all the big political decisions are made. Now, let's look through the second part, culture. As I mentioned in the first part, Beijing has a super duper long history. But we are now living in the 21st century. That the traditional Chinese culture seems pretty different from the modern Western culture. Combining the two total different culture seems pretty hard for every single city. Unbelievably, by the past couple years, Beijing did it. If it's your first time being in Beijing, you must go visit the shocking big palace, Forbidden City, or climb the Great Wall. Feel the pride of standing on such a great piece of art built by people in history. Maybe you're not very into the old stuff. You may follow the Chang'an Street, and you can visit Guomao, the tallest building in Beijing. We can drive to Bird Nest to experience the sports spirit. You can listen to some Beijing opera. Or you can also visit NCPA, National Center for Performing Arts, to listen to some opera. Maybe you're like me, love to eat. Then I highly recommend you to try out some Beijing traditional food, like Lü Da Gun, Rolling Dung. Okay, maybe not this one, yeah, this one. Or you can also try out some Beijing roast duck from 全聚德 or 便宜坊. At the same time, there are also some very very good steakhouse or coffee shop around Beijing. Mark my words, there's no need to worry about food in Beijing. Now, let's talk about the third part, global. Being the capital and the political center of China, Beijing is now a very international city. One simple but straightforward example is that all the embassies are in Beijing, which bring a total number of people travel between Beijing and their home country. Also, Beijing is usually where the presidents from other countries will first visit. That makes Beijing more popular than all the other cities in China. Another great example is that before 2008 Olympic, nobody really knows anything about Beijing, barely know what does Beijing looks like, or even barely know China. During 2008 Olympic, it really surprised foreign people about how developed Beijing is, and the current stage Beijing is in. Beijing really became the symbol of China Also, the modern Beijing culture really do catches people's eyes, bringing more foreign people visit Beijing, work in Beijing, or even move to Beijing, and make Beijing even more global. The 2022 Winter Olympic will become the next big opportunity to showcase Beijing, showcase China, and I believe it will surprise all people once again about the big development since 2008. And now, let's talk about the fourth part, research and development. There are in total 3,937 headquarters of different companies in Beijing. Within the 3,937 headquarters, 97 of them are in China top 500 company list, and 48 of them are global 500 headquarters, which Beijing is the city with the most global 500 headquarters all over the world. There are in total 82 colleges in Beijing, with tons of graduate students every year support company in Beijing. There are also lots of scientific research institutes, that over 30% of the scientific research in China are done in Beijing every year. The final part, Beijing spirit. Beijing spirit is a set of values and ideals created, tested, and practiced by generation of Beijingers, reflect the culture and motivation during the development of Beijing. There are four words representing Beijing spirit: patriotism, innovation, inclusiveness, and virtue. Patriotism is the core of Beijing spirit. Innovation is the motivation. Inclusiveness is the broad mind. And virtue is the spiritual quality. These four words summarize Beijing's deep national feeling and real understanding on traditional culture and humanistic spirit. My presentation is coming to an end. Although it only covers a little bit of Beijing, I hope you learned something about Beijing. If you want to know more about Beijing, then just bring your suitcase and go visit Beijing. Feel the life, the culture, and the spirit. Make the ground shake.